Good afternoon, respected jury members, seniors, and my fellow colleagues. I'll be presenting biological fluid saliva as a forensic diagnostic tool. Next slide, please. As the title suggests, the aim of this e-poster is to review the significance of saliva as an invaluable tool for forensic data collection and analysis. Saliva plays a critical role in genomics, proteomics, metabolomics, and informatics, which is an important discriminating element in forensic biology. And as we know, the constituents from the blood enters the saliva by transcellular passive intracellular diffusion and active transport by extracellular filtration within the salivary glands or through the gingival crevice, and hence saliva can be compared to plasma in proteomic constituents. The saliva droplets found in and around the vicinity of a crime scene can provide crucial information that could aid in solving the case. Next slide, please, ma'am. So the saliva can be collected from dried saliva stains, which are left on bite marks or lip prints, and it can lead to comparative identification, which is when the suspect is unknown. And it can be also used for reconstructive identification. That is when the suspect is, it can be used for reconstructive identification. That is when the suspect is unknown. And it can be used as a comparative identification, which is when the suspect is known. And this can be done through the detection of various salivary signature constituents in these samples. The presence and absence of saliva can be tested by the presence of alpha amylase, as done in the FIDEBUS forensic salivary test. And the other methods of detection of saliva are lipid stain identification, the cell IgAE test, and the polylite. Ma'am, next slide, please. Coming to the metabolites which are found in the saliva, salivary samples can reflect the free fraction of even the tiniest bit of drug which is present in the system. Which can be done through the methods like radioimmunoassay, and a recent non-instrumental immunodiagnostic assay has been developed in Germany, which is known as the drug wipe. And aside from that, saliva can also detect heavy metal poisoning, and the detection of such psychotropic drugs and ethanol levels in saliva can also lead to better road and traffic safety aside from forensic contribution. Thank you, ma'am. It can be the salivary samples can be collected and which can be stimulated or unstimulated saliva, and the methods can be passive drool methods, oral swab, infant swab, spitting method, or suction method, and it can be collected from animate or inanimate objects, which is like daily use objects such as glasses, bottles, or cigarette butts, chewing gums, etc., and bite marks. And how to detect is by enzymes like starch amylase phosphatase and salts like thiocyanate and nitrates, as mentioned before. But due to the limitations and variable sensitivity, newer methods have been developed, which consists of lasers and ultraviolet light, quartz arch tube, argon ion lasers, such as fluorescence spectroscopy. And coming to the methodology, the dashes of saliva, which are left behind as in cases of sexual assault by either the abuser or the victim during defense, such as the bite mark, it can be recuperated using a solitary wet cotton or moist filter paper, which is laid passively onto the site. And the advantage of using saliva samples collected from the bite mark is that because technical hitches like nature of the skin being distortable and elastic leads to the failure as a medium for impression. And salivary samples from the bite marks can also detect 90% of ABO DNA profiles from epithelial cells, which can serve as genetic fingerprinting. With incorporation of periodontics, microbial fingerprinting by oral microbial data collection, as well as salivary biomarker analysis, can boost the field of forensic odontology exponentially. And DNA analysis from saliva can be done as the cells in the saliva are derived mainly from mitochondrial DNA, which is formally derived maternally. And if there is a difficulty in finding a close kin or of the subject, then the distant maternal relative can be used as a reference source of identification. And DNA methylation based on tissue-specific methylation patterns gives an operator-independent result, which can be multiplexed with short tandem repeats typing without loss of the sample. And other protein identification tools, such as fluorescence spectroscopy, mass spectrometry, and Raman spectroscopy can also be used. Sorry, ma'am. Yes. For the sex animation using saliva, the incidence and detection of sex chromatin bar bodies in female and F bodies in males, then sex hormone levels of testosterone and 17B estradiol by radioimmunoassay can also be used. Then using primers specific towards intron 1 of immunogenin gene, salivary samples from males exhibit two bands, whereas females show only one band. So overall, the advantage of saliva as a clinical tool may prove to be more beneficial as compared to serum and tissues because the collection is relatively easier, it's painless, and can be done in any age group. It's easy storage and transportation and greater sensitivity and correlations with the levels in blood, and it's safer as compared to handling blood specimens with associated risk of contamination and transmission of disease. As to conclude my presentation, I would like to say that saliva constitutes DNA, proteins, and bacterial signatures, which can provide a variety of data, and so oral microbiomes and salivary biomarker data banks for different population and locations should be created, which can substantiate its role in forensic science and research. Thank you.